salutes the crowd, and now he waits for the man he hopes to beat, the IBF world champion from the Philippines, Rolando Bohol. Well, there have been some great Filipino fighters over the years. It's a country that's produced a good few world champions. And here's the latest in the line, Rolando Bohol. Robed and hooded in white. The champion. So we have the men in the ring, and now the national anthem. Britain have a long tradition in world flyweight champions, going all the way back to Jimmy Wilde in 1916. The last man to hold the world flyweight championship from this country was Charlie Magri, and Charlie is with me at the ringside. We'll get an opinion from him after the announcement.
India and Terry Lawless present a flyweight contest of 12 3-minute rounds at 8 stones for the IBF flyweight championship of the world. Presenting and introducing in this corner, ladies and gentlemen, from the Philippines, the flyweight champion of the world, Rolando Bohol. And from Croydon, ladies and gentlemen, the challenger, the flyweight champion of Europe, Duke McKenzie. At the weigh-in, both boxers scaled 8 stones exactly. And the officials for this contest, ladies and gentlemen, appointed by the IBF, the judges are Lou Talbot from the USA, Walter Cavalieri from Italy, Roland Dakin from England, the referee from New Zealand, Mr. Bruce McTavish, and the IBF supervisor, Mrs. Hiawatha Knight.
Well, as I said, Charlie McGree, who held this title or a version of it not so long ago. How do you look at this, Charlie? How's it going to go?
Well, I think this guy looks a very, very, very strong fella, and I think Duke's got to really box him for the first four rounds. He's got to just keep on his left hand and just confuse him a bit, because he looks very tough, doesn't he?
Well, I think most Filipinos are, you know that.
I know that, yeah.
So here we go, Duke McKenzie on the left, much the taller of these two men, the European champion. He's 5'7" tall, and he'll have a 3-inch height advantage here, and reach advantage, consequently, over the champion Rolando Bohol. We have a New Zealand referee who, strangely enough, lives in Manila, which is where Bohol comes from. But to offset that, there's a British judge among the three sitting ringside to do the scoring. So the Filipino champion in the white trunks, boxing southpaw at the moment, but he might go the other way around as well. He can switch. 28 fights, Bohol. He's won 24, but only three inside the distance. And two defeats. The last man to beat him was another South Korean. He meets a lot of them. Chun Hyu. And that was in South Korea in July 86. Last time he was beaten. And the only other time he's ever boxed outside his own country. Well, as Charlie was saying, McKenzie starting this cautiously enough, as he must do. And test out what Bohol has to offer. What we do know of his previous fights, we know that Bohol can come through 15 rounds. He'll only have to go 12 here if he goes all the way. But he can come through 15 rounds with a cut, come very strong at the start, and then cruise through to the finish to win a points title. That's how he won the title, with a cut on his right eye. So we believe him to be a strong, tough and aggressive man over the opening few rounds. Well, McKenzie has waited a long time for this chance, but at last it's come. McKenzie from that famous boxing family, which includes Clinton McKenzie, who is somewhere here tonight, surely, the former British and European light welterweight champion. And if McKenzie can make good use of this long reach advantage, then he's got great chances here of bringing a version of the world flyweight title back to Britain. Dangerous looking little attack there at the end of that first round. Charlie, you know everything about Duke McKenzie, because he was the last man you boxed.
That's right.
Tell us what he's like to meet.
I think he's a very good fighter under pressure. I really, honestly underestimated him when I boxed him. I thought myself like he's going to be another one of these British fighters I can just knock over. But he surprised me highly. You know, he's really very good under pressure, and he's a good fighter off the ropes. But this guy here tonight looks very, very sharp, and he's a bit awkward being a southpaw.
But he's got the same problem as you had with McKenzie. I mean, McKenzie's so tall for the weight, isn't he, and long reach.
But he seems to be getting through occasionally with that left hand, and it's going to be a 12 round fight, so it's just a matter of time. I think McKenzie's got to stick to his boxing a bit more.
Mm-hmm. You're obviously very worried about this guy, Bohol, aren't you?
I am. He looks a lot better than what I expected him to be, and when he's shaped up there, and he's a very cagey customer.
Bohol comes out for round two against the challenger Duke McKenzie, the champion of Europe, former British champion. Wearing IBF gloves tonight, with the thumb attached to the side of the glove, so they can't use the thumb independently. of the rest of the glove. Safety measure. Bohol never was an amateur. Came straight into the game as a pro in 1984. Bohol is the 14th Filipino boxer to win a world title. Using his big ring, it's a good advantage, using his physical advantages, try to keep Bohol away from him in these early stages. Bruce McTavish from New Zealand, the referee.
Break, step back.
Bohol sticking to the southpaw stance, although he can turn. McKenzie taking this very coolly. Just looking left hand to the top of Butte's head. Charlie puts him under a lot of pressure very quickly, suddenly, doesn't he? Suddenly comes forward and he looks fierce.
Well, I think, you know, like, the pressure he's putting Duke under, I think it's frightening to sort of, I'm getting a feeling a little bit frightened for him himself, but I think what he's got to do, he's got to feint more with that jab, be a bit more positive with it when he catches him, you know what I mean? That Bohol, he's a very dangerous customer. I think he's a good worthy champion.
Do you think either of them is having a bit of trouble with the weight? They both weighed exactly 8 stone at the weigh-in, and Duke, I've always thought, must be having trouble at 5'7", keeping down to 8 stone all these years.
Well, I think that day before weighing in must have done him a right favour, really, because he looks a lot stronger now for it, and the Filipino, same, in the same...
How
same
many pounds do you think Duke might have put on since yesterday?
I think he could have put on a good 5 pounds.
Really? So he could be 8'5" now.
That's right.
The other guy a bit lighter. Bohol, the champion in the white shorts. Aggressive little man. But for the large part, being kept at bay by that long left lead. That's a good-looking right from McKenzie. If he can get that employed a few times, that could be a very significant punch. He picked him up well with that. McKenzie showing signs here. He wants to step the pace up a bit. McKenzie's had experience in American rings in the early part of his pro career. His manager, Mickey Duff, took him out there and gave him, I think, 5 fights in the States. And he won them all in the inside the distance. Good experience.
Thank you.
Another good right. McKenzie settling down, gaining in confidence, as long as he doesn't leave himself too exposed.
Okay, break, step back.
Previous two rounds, the champion has come very strongly at the end of the round. And again he's doing it. He seems to know when they're in the last minute of the round. McKenzie getting the better of these exchanges. That was another right low from the champion. Good round for McKenzie. He loosened up a bit there, and once or twice he threw very dangerous looking right hands.
Well, I think he's got to do a lot more of that, Harry. You know, he's going round to that opposite side, to the left of his serve right, and I think like he's got to throw that right hand a bit more often.
Well, we're a quarter of the way through, but he started well. You said he had to come out and box. He's done that, hasn't he? He's kept the man at bay for most of the time. That right's coming up again here, Charlie. Look, we'll just have a look at this McKenzie right here. Picked him up well with this. Nice punch.
Very good punch that was, Harry. I think he's got to do a bit more of that now. The pace is going to step up, and I think that Bohol is going to come out a bit more harder this round. McKenzie's got to really keep his guards up.
Okay, well, let's hope he does. There's the face of the champion. And there's a glimpse of Lloyd Hannigan, Britain's world welterweight champion, keen observer of this. A lot of good fighters around the ringside here tonight, including the one sitting next to me, Charlie Magri. That's a good right hand. He staggers the champion with it. Best punch he's thrown yet, McKenzie. McKenzie handling this at the moment very well. He's using his reach, and he's very quick to get the right hand in. But these are moments when Bohol might be very dangerous indeed, when he feels himself being picked off like that. Good left hook. At the moment, McKenzie doing everything right. McKenzie's got the distance judged absolutely right at the moment. He's picking his man off, and he's stepping back where he's out of harm's way.
Keep your head up.
Moving nicely as he comes in, McKenzie, making the other man miss. Bohol is still dangerous, let's not forget that. But his record doesn't show himself to be an enormous... doesn't show him to be an enormous puncher. He's only stopped three men in 24 wins. When he won the title and when he defended it for the first time, he had to go 15 rounds. Good punch. And at this point, point, McKenzie is very well on top indeed. Looking strong and forcing the champion back. Another low punch from Bohol. Well, what about that, Charlie? He's doing very well, isn't he?
That was a brilliant round by McKenzie. I thought that was fantastic. You know, I seen him there just holding on there for a little bit. McKenzie standing with a left hook there.
Well, there were one or two very, very good punches from McKenzie there, and I think we're going to see a sample or two of them coming up. Here we are. Let's have a look at this. Which is this? Top of the head. Now let's have our overhead camera on it and see what we can see from this. Here's he. Top of the head and the uppercut and a left hook. Yeah, that's, you see, he really had him going always there. What do you make of that, Charlie? Good?
Well, it's going to definitely hotten up this fight, I think.
Yes, I think the champion's going to have to work a bit harder, and probably will. Bohol in the white shorts. McKenzie from Croydon. On his British title, the night McGuigan beat Eusebio Pedrosa in the football ground at Queen's Park Rangers, June 1985, and won his European title, of course, against Charlie Magri. This is another caution for low punching, three times, and he's going to have marks deducted for that. So, this is turning out at the moment to be not too happy an experience for Bohol. He's getting himself into trouble with the referee, and certainly getting himself into trouble with McKenzie. But remember, the man's still strong. And Filipinos don't give up their titles lightly. Forcing hard now, but still being picked up on the right hand. Bohol forcing himself back into this. Kenzie needs to work hard, go with him. Boxing beautifully again. Can't be much doubt, Charlie, that after these early rounds, McKenzie's well in front now, I would think, particularly after that caution about the low punching.
Well, I'm making him in front there anyway, and I think he's boxing beautifully. As the fight goes on, he's boxing better and better. I think he's got to throw a few more right hands for my liking, because every time he throws that right hand, he knocks that other guy off balance.
It's very noticeable that once Duke eases up a bit, this guy comes at him very, very strongly, doesn't he?
I think
he only needs a bit of encouragement.
I think he senses that Duke slows up a little bit and he just comes on stronger.
They've got a bit of a swelling coming there, so they're trying to iron it away with that steel. So, a little bit of concern in the Filipinos' corner. But, fingers crossed, from Britain's point of view at the moment, with five rounds completed, it's going well. Bohol taking the full rest. Scheduled for 12 rounds, this is the sixth. Again, he gets picked up on that right hand. Bohol's got no defense against that. Slightly here. Never been allowed to fight this the way he wants to fight it. He wants to swarm all over McKenzie, and he can't do it. McKenzie picking off the Filipino's punches on his gloves and getting his own counters in. Certainly a very impressive piece of boxing by McKenzie. He's keeping control of this very coolly. And we're very close to the halfway stage now. And the dangerous moments for McKenzie come when he tries to mix it. Managed a little grin as he went back to the corner, but I don't think he's got too much to grin about, do you, Charlie?
Well, I think McKenzie's getting better every round. He's looked really good in that round, and I think he's taking over now. Looking at it from my point of view, I think he's in front.
How would you gauge the two of them to go the 12 rounds? Who do you think is going to be the stronger over 12?
Well, to me now, it's looking like McKenzie's getting stronger all the time, and he's looking at his face. He looks so happy with himself.
He's taken very few punches, actually, hasn't he? Whereas Bohol's taken a lot.
He's using that left hand at a great extent. I tell you, he's looking really good, and I think he's getting better every round.
Still worried about that right eye of Bohol's. Still working to keep the swelling down, if they can. So, the first half of the fight is completed, and it's been McKenzie's. There can't be any doubt about that. He must be ahead.
Seventh down, round seven.
Now, what is Bohol going to do about it? Because he must know that he's losing his grip on the fight and on his championship. You can see Bohol trying to work away, find a way to get past that long left lead of McKenzie's. Weaving this way and that, trying to get past, trying to get the right hand over the top of it somehow. Where to score and do some damage. And he hasn't had much success so far. McKenzie needs to keep that jab coming from a distance. That's a good right again. Bohol isn't quite so keen to come in now. Even when McKenzie slacks off, he's not too quick to come in. But he could still be very dangerous if McKenzie gets careless. Very fed up with the feel of that left hand in his face. Well, that wasn't quite such a dominant round for McKenzie as some of the others, was it? He allowed Bohol to do a little more work there.
Well, I think McKenzie's doing a lovely bit of box fighting there as well, and it's going to get tougher now, isn't it? Because the guy thinks he's behind.
Well, he's sure to think that. He was taught to box, Bohol, by the great former world champion Flash Elordi. You must remember him. He was a world junior lightweight champion for 7 years in the 1960s. He's dead now, but he taught this boy to box and also turned him into a southpaw. And that's why occasionally he goes back to his old way of the other way around. But he's now managed by the widow of Flash Elordi, and one of those trainers in the corner there is the son of that great fighter. So it's a romantic story, but it might be a night when things are going to go wrong for him, Charlie.
That's right. For the experience he's had, this boy, he's a bloody good fighter. You know, he ain't had hardly any experience, really.
28 fights, it's not a lot. No amateur experience. You had a few years as an amateur before you ever went pro, didn't you?
That's right, Aaron.
Quite a few. So, round 8. And McKenzie showing every signs here of fashioning what could be a remarkable victory. I think we all rather feared this man Bohol and that it might be a very, very tough fight. The way McKenzie is conducting it, he's keeping himself out of trouble and giving the champion plenty. It has to be said that although he's getting picked off all the time, Bohol is keeping his cool. He hasn't gone mad, and he's still trying to box his way through this. left hand of Bohol's is getting dangerously near the borderline again. Every now and again he digs it in down below. He's also getting one or two right hands well back on the body of McKenzie, but he hasn't been cautioned for that. Bohol complaining to the referee, I think, about McKenzie's head. Philippine is struggling, and there's blood around, and I think the champion is cut. In fact, I'm sure he is. Bohol is cut somewhere near the right eye, which is the eye that gave him so much trouble when he won the title. But he came through that time. There's blood flying around from somewhere. Looks to be more in the centre of his forehead. The sight of that injury on Bohol's face will give McKenzie even more encouragement. Now let's see where they work. You can see where it is now. It is in fact near the bridge of the nose, above the left eye in the corner. And a very awkward looking, look at that, diagonal cut. Very strange place to get a cut, Charlie.
It's a very bad cut actually, Harry, and I think it can take a lot of work to stop that bleeding.
It's an unusual place, isn't it? Down like
that. Very bad.
Referee is having a look at it, Mr. McTavish. But at the moment, I don't think it's bad enough for them to stop it. And the referee's walked away. I'm not sure they've stopped the bleeding, but they've tried. And that looks certain to open up again very quickly. So two-thirds of this fight completed now, and the champion cut a rather nasty diagonal vertical cut above the left eye near the bridge of the nose. And that might turn Bohol into a very desperate fighter now. Keeping his cool before, but he probably can't afford to now. Beginning to seep quite badly from that cut on the champion's face. Bohol is trying very hard now to bring one big punch out of the bag here to try to turn the tide, which is going all the time against him. The ninth round. There's three more to come after this. McKenzie well out in front. His man is cut. And the IBF World Flyweight title is now dangling. Very temptingly in front of McKenzie. Bohol tries, or how he struggles, He can't overcome the superior boxing skill and his long reach of Duke McKenzie, the European champion, who's now driving his man back around the ring, and these are desperate moments for Bohol. He's looking very close to defeat. The ninth. He may have trouble coming out to the tenth, the way this is going. Well, I don't know, Charlie, never pays to be too premature, but I think we might have a world champion here on our hands. This man's looking desperate now.
Well, since he got cut there, Duke McKenzie's grown so much in confidence. He's looking very good.
Is there any way he can come back now, do you think?
I don't think he's got any chance of coming back. The only way he can come back is landing a lucky punch here.
And I don't think he is that big a puncher. The referee's having a close look at that cut. Here's some more of McKenzie's action in that ninth round when he began to chase Bohol all round the ring. And there was nothing the champion could do about it. He really was at bay here.
I think McKenzie took over now.
Yep. Well, I think he took over from the early part, and he did exactly what you said, box him properly in the early rounds. Three rounds to go, and it's got to be neck or nothing now for the champion if he wants to keep his title. But he looked very close to defeat at the end of the ninth. And again, he picks up a right hand early on. McKenzie's finding him every place on the body. He's taken this champion apart, bit by bit. Done a ring mechanics job on him. Looked like another low right from Bohol to me. No caution. That's a good left. The champion's still dangerous. He's getting the left through a bit more often now. Back in there now, taking control of it again. McKenzie finishing the round strongly again. Hurting him with body punches. Bohol creased over. There's nowhere to go to escape. Soaking up punch after punch. Holds on for dear life. Grits his teeth. He's hurt. Another terrific finish by McKenzie. I was just thinking, Charlie, you had your last fight against Duke McKenzie. It wouldn't be, I mean, if he wins this title and it looks as though he's going to, you can always say, well, it took a world champion in the end to put me out of
That's
the
right.
ring.
That's right. I'm really proud of Duke McKenzie tonight because he's boxing a really good fight. He's boxing and fighting as well. And this guy looks like he's really under pressure now. He's pulling faces. They don't usually change their expressions, these Filipinos, but he's, He's really pulling a lot of faces in there, quite.
Well, I think he was hurt particularly by the body punching. In that he's beginning to look very white too, isn't he? It's really hard going for him.
Well, I think Duke McKenzie's gave him a big shock here because he can fight as well as box.
He certainly looks in trouble. Almost as though he can hardly bear to get up and come out for another round.
He's lost a lot of eye in this fight.
He's quite white-faced.
Second round, round 11.
Two rounds to go. Here's the champion. Has the champion still got something here to turn this? Or is McKenzie going to pull off? Oh, the glove's split. McKenzie's glove is split by the look of it. No, it's not. It's something on it. The grease. That's what it was. A white blob of grease, which they've wiped off. Look for a moment, for all the world as though it had been split. Good right hand to McKenzie again. His ring mastery here has been outstanding. And every time he hits Bohol now, Bohol looks as though he's almost going to go down. He really has given Bohol a savage working over. But the man from the Philippines is still standing there, and while he's standing there, he can be dangerous. To admire Bohol's courage at this point, because he really is soaking up some punishment, and he's still trying very hard, and I think every round is agony for him now. Got him! Over he goes in the 11th round. What a performance this has been by McKenzie, and I don't think he's got the strength to get up off the floor. He's made it. Is he going to be allowed to carry on? He is. He only just beat the count. Over he goes again. He's absolutely sold out. All the strength has been drained from him. Six. The towel has come in from his corner, and McKenzie has collapsed in sheer ecstasy. Charlie, that was a performance.
That was a brilliant performance. That was. It's a pleasure to see someone like that, and I can say he beat me now. Don't feel disappointed about saying it now.
A great performance, what now? I mean, he did everything right.
Yeah. He did. Towards the end there, Boxer fell so badly that he got confused and he didn't know what to do.
Right. Well, Charlie, I'm going to get up there and congratulate him. Shall I take your congratulations with him?
You tell him that from me, yeah.
Okay, well,
definitely.
Hold on a minute. We're going to have a, before I get up there, we're going to see how it all finished. Here we go. Champion in the white shorts. I said at this point that he looked in agony, and he was. And that was the first of the knockdowns, and he only just beat the count from that. It was touch and go. But he did bravely clamber up and went on. And then it was all too much for him. This is the same knockdown again from another angle. Sprawled flat on his back. I never thought he was going to make it.
After 2 minutes.
Okay, well, I'm going to get up in the ring, and Charlie, I'll leave you to talk with Steve Ryder while I'm gone.
And the new IBF flyweight champion of the world, Duke McKenzie.
Yeah, well, Harry makes his way into the ring to greet the new champion. Charlie, what impressed you most about Duke's performance tonight?
Well, the way he came on round after round, and towards the end of the rounds, he was coming on so strong for his size and making the weight so good, he looked brilliant.
Do you see any great difference between Duke now and the man you faced a couple of years ago?
Well, there's a lot of difference at the moment because he's had a lot more experience, and the confidence is growing on him so much, and now winning that title, he must be over the moon.
What do you think that he can go on and achieve now, because he's got one version of the world title?
Well, I think he can win the WBA, he can beat that Basso bloke. I don't think he's very good at all, but good fight, don't get me wrong, but I think Duke McKenzie could beat him.
Okay, Charlie, I think Harry's got his man now. Let's hear from the new champion.
Yeah, come on, Colin.
Obviously, emotion still running high there in the corner. Lloyd Hannigan giving his congratulations as well. Very happy scenes, Charlie, aren't they?
That's right, it is happy scenes there. All his brothers in the ring. Duke McKenzie can't even get his senses here. I think he's giving a little cry.
Huh?
Are they ready?
Ready,
let's go.
I don't want to go around
there. Right, Harry, I think, is with the new champion. Your turn.
Congratulations, that was a tremendous performance. Are you all right? Can you talk to me? You're overwhelmed, I know what it's like. What can you say to me?
Oh, eh? No,
that was an amazing performance. Jesus, you took the guy apart. You absolutely took him apart.
You took him apart.
It's just been a long time coming.
You waited a long time, that's right.
We waited a long time.
The night's here and you've done it.
Yeah.
It was tremendous.
Yeah, they've done it in style, Larry.
I can't believe
it. In style.
Tell me about, how did you plan it? What was the plan?
There was no plan. I just knew I had to go with him, Mario.
But you booked him so well in the early stages. He was so strong.
I thought he was going to knock me out.
Come on.
He was never going to knock you out, my son. Yeah. You always kept him out. But what a finish. What do you think of that finish you just put in there?
That was brilliant. It was brilliant.
Oh, I can't.
Duke, the champion. Well done. Congratulations. And Charlie Magri told me to congratulate you. So that was great. Duke, thanks very much.
Good fight.